Mulching is strongly recommended to reduce weeds and has added benefits. Mulch helps to maintain soil moisture. It protects the soil during heavy rains. Mulch improves the soil quality and the soil nutrient level after it decomposes. Mulch can also help prevent soil-borne diseases from splashing onto or reaching the leaves of pepper plants. Light-colored mulch keeps aphids away. Even when mulching, hand weeding may still be necessary, especially between plants in the rows. Usually, these can be just pulled out. Use your machete or hoe to carefully remove these weeds. When the plant is big enough to cover much of the ground, this too will help to reduce weed growth. Remember, don't rely on chemical herbicides alone. Use mulches and cover crops to reduce weeds and to improve soil fertility. Aphids. Aphids, commonly called plant lice, are very small, soft-bodied insects, yellowish-green to dark-green in color, that usually feed at the back of leaves. They pierce the plant tissue and suck sap from it. Aphids pass out a sugary liquid called honeydew that attracts ants and other insects which feed on it. Ants protect them from their natural enemies. A black fungus called sooty mold grows on honeydew. This reduces food production by the leaves. Very importantly, aphids can carry viruses on their mouthparts. Two major viruses spread by aphids in Jamaica are potato virus Y, PVY, and tobacco etch virus, TEV. Management. Using ICM, aphids are not likely to become a serious problem in the crop. It is necessary to prevent aphids from feeding on pepper plants because once they feed, viruses can enter the plant. This happens even if an insecticide later kills the aphid. The insect-proof nursery protects the young plants from aphids. Once transplanted, aphids can be drawn away from the pepper by a barrier or trap crop planted around the field. Corn has worked quite well in local trials so far. Other more suitable barrier crops are, however, being looked for. The barrier crop is planted 2 to 3 weeks before the pepper is to be transplanted, so that they are at least 45 centimeters or 18 inches tall at transplanting time. The barrier should be planted at least 1.8 meters or 6 feet wide. The plants should be very close. For example, corn should be planted 15 by 15 centimeters or 6 by 6 inches apart. Make a narrow space of about 60 centimeters or 2 feet to enter and leave the field. When aphids feed on the barrier crop, they lose virus from their mouthparts. So, if they move into the pepper crop, they will have little or no virus left to infect the pepper. This gives the pepper field a longer productive life. Aphids are killed by tiny wasps, brightly colored ladybird beetles, and other natural enemies. Use insecticides only if necessary to avoid killing natural enemies and making the situation worse. When many aphids are seen on the barrier crop, they may be sprayed to reduce movement into the pepper field. Use approved insecticides. Once again, check with your extension officer to be sure which ones are safe and approved. Follow the manufacturer's instructions. For example, dimethoate or admire should be used only before fruit development. During fruiting, insecticidal soaps and other chemicals acceptable to the importing country may be sprayed. Broad mite. The broad mite is a very tiny relative of insects. It is very difficult to see without a magnifying glass, but it is likely to be the major pest of peppers. The adult mite is whitish in color and has 8 legs. It scrapes plant surfaces and feeds on the juices. Because they are so tiny and cannot be seen normally, you can only tell when broad mite is present in the field by the damage that it causes on the plant. Affected plants have leaves that may be stunted, twisted, and curled down. Buds do not open normally. Young leaves are brownish in color. Backs of larger leaves become brown and shiny. Flowers will fall off, and fruits develop a similar russeting and remain small, tough, and marble-like. In severe infestations, affected young plant parts fall off, leaving bare shoots, which may also be stunted. These signs will remain for some time after the mite population is reduced. Broad mite damage is sometimes mistaken for virus damage. If in doubt, check with your extension officer. Broad mites normally cause more severe problems when insecticides are misused, killing natural enemies that would otherwise keep these mites under control. Ladybird beetles, a small bug and predatory mites, feed on broad mites. Management. ICM uses a knowledge about the pest to prevent it from becoming a problem. Like insects, broad mite can become resistant to chemicals used against them. Therefore, the best way to control broad mite is to use good field sanitation and other suitable practices from the beginning. Proper weed control will help avoid broad mite damage. Broad mites also feed on several other plants, such as cotton, citrus, pawpaw, cucumber, and grapes. Avoid having those crops near to your pepper field, or make sure that broad mites are not on them. Check fields at least once weekly for mites or their damage. Use a small x10 or x15 magnification hand lens. This is a wise investment for any serious pepper farmer. For farmers without a hand lens, when one or more out of every 10 plants, that is to say 10% of plants, show broad mite damage, a pesticide such as Topcop, Pegasus, or Vertimec may be used. Farmers with hand lenses should check several plants first to see if live broad mites are present. If none is seen, do not spray. Make further application only where regular field checks show live broad mites. Where only a few plants are badly affected, you may spray those plants and two or three plants deep, all around them as seen here. This will protect natural enemies, avoid mite outbreaks, and save money.